welcome to another episode in my build log series of the Trumpeter 1-200 scale model of the Titanic. Today I am doing a few little jobs. First and foremost, I am doing the forward railings on the forecastle deck. And I'll be interested to get people's take on this, but when I was putting them in, I did think to myself, are these the most photographed railings in human history? I don't know, but you see, you know, photos of the wreck, they're everywhere, and of course you've got Jack and Rose in the film at the front. It was just a weird thought that occurred to me. Interested to know what people's thoughts are on that. I've also fitted some ventilation to the boat deck, so I'm going to start at the back and work forward again. So I'm doing the fourth funnel ventilators and also any ventilators that are on the roof of the first class smoking room as well. And that should be about it. I've got a little surprise at the end of the video though, so do hang around for that. Without any further ado, let's crack on. Right, as you can probably guess, what we're up to today is the railings on the forecastle deck. And I'm going to start with the absolute prow of the ship and do the actual bow railings. So, I'll get those cut out and then we'll crack on from there. Now, in order to bend this, I am using a circular tool, which is roughly the same radius as I want bend to be. Plonk that right in the middle of the workpiece. And then use your hands to manipulate. Now, I don't think that'll be enough of a bend, but we'll see. It's not bad, actually. I'm just going to cut the camera and I'll have a look at some more photos of Titanic. I forgot to show in the last episode, by the way, this anchor is just held in place with a couple of magnets. So there's one, where are they? I forget now. I think there's two there and one there, and they just mate up against magnets in the actual base of the forecastle deck. So nice and simple, and that holds it relatively securely, but allows you to take it out. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give a wee daub of glue. Now this is just an interesting thing to note. I've had a little issue with the positioning of this bad boy. When I put my second segment of railing up against it, it doesn't quite match up with these parts lowered down the forecastle. I'll just zoom out. So if this part was where it originally was, up here,
The railing doesn't match up with all three of these. If I shift it down a couple of mil, everything works out nicely. So I think that's what I'm going to have to do, really, because I don't have many options here. Fortunately, with a really, really deadly sharp knife, I am able to cut under this, sever the bond, and remove it. A little bit of sanding, clean that up, bonk it back down, and any damage to the deck will be hidden underneath the fixing again. So, not to worry about, but worth noting if you're using the same bits on the model that I am. Right, first bit done. As you can see, really nicely joins into that forward section. Beautiful bit of railing, and it really does add a sense of scale again to the ship. Now, here we are at the front, and in due course, of course, I'll be adding a ladder here and also a set of stairs. But as we can see, the railing is just a wee bit too long. Now, this has happened on a few occasions. It happened over at the stern section as well, you know. It's not something to be completely concerned about. But, of course, what I don't want to do is cut the railing off and then have five railings sort of floating in midair without a vertical stand, because that really wouldn't look all that realistic. So what I think I should do instead, I think I would be better to cut the excess from this point here. And that will make the sort of surgery job of getting this in place a bit harder, but I think that will give us a better result in the end. And I think just when your eye sort of flows over the model, it will look a bit more realistic. If you don't understand what I mean, I will show you now. Right, there we go. So as you can see, what I did was I chopped out a small section, bonded each of the railings together. That was fiddly. And then glued along the length, and Bob's your uncle. We have a completed section of railing. If you're interested, here is the piece that was removed. Probably about, ooh, I don't know, 3 mil, 4 mil, something like that. So not a lot, but enough to be pretty obvious when on the model. So we will now turn our attention to t'other side and get that railing done as well. The other side was done as well, but you'll just have to take my word for it because Robbie did not hit film. So that's unfortunate. But anyway, all done. And let's now move on to some ventilation. So here we are, all of the ventilation equipment for the roof of the smoking room. Need to paint these in white now. Right, I'm just getting ready to put the ventilation equipment onto the model. But before I do that, of course, what I need to do is put down these heavy wear plates. And of course, this makes perfect sense. You don't put heavy equipment down onto soft wooden decking. You put a plate down first, to make sure it doesn't sink through the floor or damage it in any way. So I need to add these first, and then I will go on and add the ventilation on top. Now, these are all very lovely, but it's all a little bit pristine for me. And of course, we don't really want pristine, particularly not on ventilators. So, I'm just going to add a relatively small amount of black wash. And this should sort of tone it down a bit. Make things look a wee bit more grimy, which is what we're after. So there we go, that's all the ventilators in, and as you can see, the black wash just takes the edge off the shininess, makes grates stand out a bit more, makes things look a little bit more used, but not overdone, hopefully, just a bit more sort of in use. I've also added this mystery box. I think for a long time people didn't know what this box was, and certainly the book I have on modelling the Titanic is quite open about not knowing what the box did. But I think more recently someone's worked out that it was a sandbox. So there you go, that's been added as well. Now, I've now taken the ship outside because people have been asking me to do some photography on it with natural light for quite a while. And as you can see, we've had plenty of snow here in the UK, which does quite effectively light the model. So I'll now close the video out with some photos and videos that I've taken. Might even use some familiar music. Now, sorry to disappoint Titanic film fans, but Jack and Rose will not be remaining on the model. They're not permanently attached. I am first and foremost trying to model Titanic, the actual ship that sailed. And of course, Jack and Rose are fictitious characters, so they're not going to stick around. But very nice to have that 3D printed model of them to get those shots anyway. And so that concludes today's video. A short one. But nice to get all of the forward railings done, they are quite iconic, and it's really nice to have got the ship outside into some natural light to get some photos of it. So, as I say, I hope you've enjoyed it. If you've got any questions or comments, pop them down below and I'll do my best to get back to you. If you've enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. It's always very helpful if people like and subscribe. And I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.